after understanding all the concepts that we have discussed about Khosla's method and you can say the Bayliss theory, right? Each and everything. Now, you know that if you are doing irrigation in a particular area or particular land, so there can be disadvantages also. I have told you that the first disadvantage is that the pores of the soil, they can get choked because a soil irrigation water has salts in it, right? The pores can get choked. Another disadvantage is that is known as the water logging. So what is actually happening in water logging? Let us say that this is your soil and above soil you have crops, right? Okay. Now this is a groundwater table, right? Sometimes due to some reasons, this groundwater table, it can go up. It can go up and the water, it reaches the surface of earth. So what happens is that the fertility of the soil, it decreases. The germination capacity of the soil decreases, right? That is known as the water logging, right? So what are the causes of water logging? The first cause is that we can have high and excess rainfall. If high and excess rainfall is in the particular catchment area, so there can be, you can say, water logging can happen and it can be controlled by a designed irrigation system. You have to design the irrigation system, right? It can be due to high and intensive rainfall, right? So high and intensive rainfall, this can be due to high and intensive irrigation. High and excess irrigation, right? It can be due to high and excess irrigation. It can be controlled by if you have a designed irrigation system. Second, you can say second cause is that it can have high intensive rainfall. The particular catchment, high rainfall can be there, right? So it can be controlled by rainwater harvesting. So what is rainwater harvesting? This is a homework for you. So you just type on Google, what is rainwater harvesting? You will get a lot of knowledge, right? Okay. So nowadays it is a very hot topic, the rainwater harvesting, right? Now third thing is that due to improper drainage, if your field has improper drainage, then also this can happen and it can be, you can say, removed by the remedies, the proper drainage. Whatever I'm teaching, it's a, this theoretical portion, that is why I have just written it, I'm explaining you, right? The next one is the seepage from canals. You know that canals are of two types, lined and unlined canals. In case of unlined canals, there can be seepage and that can also be a cause of water logging, right? And it can be removed by if you have lined canals, right? Now let us understand about the if the pores get choked, right? The pores get choked due to salts present in irrigation water. So types of salts. So we have two types of salts. So first one is the white salt, another one is the black salt, right? White salt or black salt, and that is also known as white alkali or black alkali, right? So in white we have Na2SO4 and NaCl, and these are less harmful. Why? Because these can easily solve, these are easily soluble in water. And dear students, these questions have already been asked in examination, right? That is why I have written it, right? And your black, this question has already asked, what is black alkali, what is white alkali, right? These questions have been asked. In black, we have Na2CO2. This is very harmful. Why? Because this is insoluble in water. That is why it is harmful. So now what is the remedy? Now if this is water soluble, so if it means that if there is a lot of water on land, if I do mechanical mixing of water with the land, then this white alkali, the excess of white alkali can be removed, right? So the remedy is, that is procedure is known as leaching. So leaching, I told you that we actually flood the land with a lot of water, right? We mechanically, we do something, right? We mix the water with soil and that is how leaching takes place, okay? And this, the harmful ones, that is a black alkali, it can be removed by addition of gypsum. It is an alkaline soil and it can be removed by addition of lime. It is an acidic soil, right? So the reaction is, so Na2CO3, if you contact with gypsum, so you get CaCO3 and plus Na2SO4. And what is Na2SO4? It is water soluble. It is water soluble. That is Na2SO4 is water soluble, right? So this is a reaction. And student, this question has also been asked in examination, that lime is used for water reclamation for acidic soils and gypsum is used for alkaline soils, right? Now let us come to the leaching. Now if you have done leaching for the less harmful salts, right? So the leaching requirement, it is denoted by water to be drained out after irrigation. So if you have done irrigation, right, then some water will be left which you are draining out by the under drainage system, right, divided by the water applied during the irrigation, right? Now let us say that the drained out water is denoted by DD and the inlet water is denoted by DI. So what will be DD? How much water you are draining out will be equal to water you have applied minus the consumptive use. Whatever the water has been used by plants. Okay? So whatever the water you have applied minus the consumptive use divided by the water you have applied. If you want to calculate it in percent, you multiply it by 100 also, you get the leaching required. So direct questions have been asked. There is no trick in that. So directly questions have been asked on the leaching requirement as well as the theoretical questions have been asked. These questions have been asked very frequently in examinations, right? And the water logging, the methods of water logging, the remedies, also the causes as well as the remedies of water logging. So these questions have been asked in examinations, right? So now let's move forward to other topics. Now let us go to the gravity dams, spillways, the cross drainage works. Now let us understand these topics and finish this chapter known as the design of irrigation channels, dams and spillways. Thank you.